students, welcome the session organized by Department of Collegiate and Technical Education under the Learning Management System. Today we are discussing detailed estimation. In detailed estimation, detailed and abstract estimate of building contents are unit of measurements, rules for measurements, types of estimates, methods of taking out quantity, detailed and abstract estimation, references. Units of measurements. The units of measurements are mainly categorized for their nature, shape and size, and for making payments to the contractor. And also the principle of units of measurements normally consist the following: single unit works like doors, windows, trusses, etc. are expressed in numbers. Works consist linear measurements involve length like cornice, finishing, handrail, width, etc. expressed in running meter. Works consist aerial surfaces measurements involve area like plastering, whitewashing, partitions of specified thickness, etc. are expressed in square meters. Works consist cubical content which involves volume like earthwork, cement concrete, masonry, etc. are expressed in cubic meter. Next, rules of measurements. The rules of measurements of each item are invariably described in IS 1200. However, some of the general rules are listed below. First, measurements shall be made for finished item of work, and description of each item shall include materials, transport, labor, fabrication, tools and plants, and all types of overheads for finishing the work is required, shape, size and specification. In booking, the order shall be in sequence of length, breadth and height or thickness. All work shall be measured subject to the following tolerances. Linear measurements shall be measured to the nearest 0.01 meter. Area shall be measured to the nearest 0.01 square meter. Cubic contents shall be worked out to the nearest 0.01 cubic meter. Some types of work under different conditions and nature shall be measured separately under separate items. The bill of quantities shall fully describe the materials, proportions, workmanship and accurately represent the work to be executed. In case of masonry, stone or brick or structural concrete, the categories shall be measured separately and the height shall be described. From foundation to plinth level, from plinth level to first floor level, from first floor to second floor level, and so on. Types of estimates. Detailed estimate. The preparation of detailed estimate consists of working out quantities of various items of work and then determine the cost of each item. This is prepared in two stages: details of measurements and calculation of quantities. the complete work is divided into various items of work such as earthwork, concreting, brickwork, RCC, plastering, etc. The details of measurements are now taken from drawing and entered in respective columns of prescribed performer. The quantities are calculated by multiplying the values that are in number to depth as shown below. The detailed estimation tabular column is serial number, description of items, numbers, length, breadth, depth, quantity and remark. And second one is abstract estimate. The cost of each item of work is worked out from the quantities that already computed in the details measurement form at workable rate, but the total cost is worked out in the prescribed form is known as abstract estimate. In abstract estimate, 4% of estimated cost is allowed for supervision, contingency and unforeseen items. Abstract estimate tabular column is item or serial number, particulars, units, quantity, rate per unit, amount. The detailed estimate should accompany it with report, specification, drawings, design charts and calculation, and also standard schedules of rates. Methods of taking out quantity. The quantities like earthwork, foundation, brickwork, concrete work, plinth and superstructure, etc. can be worked by any of the following. First one is long wall, short wall method. Second one is center to center line method. And third one is partly center line and short wall method. By long wall, short wall method, prepare a detailed and abstract estimate for the following drawing for a semicircular residential building detailed in figure. Adapt long wall and short wall method and use local prevailing rates. As shown in figure, the room size, the building outer to outer dimension is 8.1 and 6.3. In this plan, semicircular wall and also the given radius all of us see here. The foundation of wall, foundation details is the width of the foundation is 0.9 meter and thickness of bed concrete is 0.3 meter. Below ground level, two steps of SSM. First step is 0.5 meter width and depth is 0.4 meter, and second step is 0.6 meter and the depth is 0.4 meter. And also basement depth is, to overall basement depth is 0.55 meter, but SSM basement is 0.4 meter and 0.15 meter is plinth concrete. The roof height is 3 meter and roof thickness is 0.12 meter. Now detailed estimation, serial number, particular number, length, breadth, depth, quantity, remark. First item is earthwork excavation, long wall L1, number 3 numbers, you see this is L1, 1 number 2 and 3, number is 3 numbers, length is, the outer to outer dimension is 6.3 minus 0.1, 0.3 by 2 and 0.3 by 2, we get L1 is 6 meter plus 1 breadth of the particular item 0.9 meter is equal to, length is equal to 6.9 meter. Number is 3, length is 6.9, width is 0.9, depth 1.1. Total quantity is 3 into 6.9 into 0.9 into 1.1. Number into length into breadth into depth. the we get quantity 20.49. and short wall S1, you see this is short wall, 3.6 is inner to inner dimension. We add half of the wall width plus half of the wall thickness, we get S1 is 3.9 minus 1 breadth. This is short wall, we deduct the 1 breadth of particular item. 3.9 minus 0.9 is equal to 3 meter. And second is S2, this is semicircular length of the wall. They given radius here, calculated S2 is 6.12 meter minus 1 breadth 0.9 is equal to 5.22. 5.22 into 0.9 into 1.1 we get 5.16. the total earthwork quantity is 40.05 cubic meter. And second item is CC bed long wall L1, similar width for CC bed. L1 is same 6 plus B is same 0.9 meter, we get 6.9 is length, and 0.9 width of the CC bed is 0.9 meter, depth is 0.3. we multiply the 3 into 6.9 into 0.9 into 0.3, we get 5.58. short wall S1, 5 numbers, 3 is the length, 0.9 into 0.3, 4.05. S2 is the one number, 5.22 into 0.9 into 0.3, we get 1.4. total quantity of CC bed is 11.03. third item, SSM work for foundation L1, 3 numbers, the length is L1 plus B, 6 plus 0.6 is equal to 6.6. 6.6 into 0.6 into 0.4, 4.75. short wall S1, 5 numbers, 3.9 minus 0.6, we get L3.3. length is 3.3 into width is 0.6 and depth is 0.4. we multiply 5 into 3.3 into 0.6 into 0.4, 3.96. S2, 1 into 5.52, length is 5.52. S2 is equal to 6.12 minus 0.6, 5.52. 5.52 into 0.6 into 0.4, 1.32. total quantity of first step SSM is 10.03. second step, long wall 3 into 6.5 into 0.5 into 0.4, 3.9. and short wall is 5 into 3.4 into 0.5 into 0.4, 3.4. S2 is 1 into 5.62 into 0.5 into 0.4, 1.12. total we get quantity 8.42. for SSM basement, long wall is 3 numbers, length is 6 plus 0.4, 6.4 into 0.4 into 0.4, depth 3.07. and short wall is S1, 5 numbers, 3.9 minus 0.4, we get 3.5 length into 0.4, 0.4 into is equal to 2.8 cubic meter. And S2 is 1 into 5.72 into 0.4 into 0.4, we get 0.91 cubic meter. Total basement quantity is 6.79, but total SSM work is below ground level plus above ground level. Overall quantity is 25.23 cubic meter. In plinth concrete, long wall L1, 3 numbers, length is 6 plus 0.4 into 0.4 into 0.15, we get 1.15. In short wall S1, 5 numbers, 3.9 minus 0.4 into 0.4 into 0.15, we get 1.05 cubic meter. S2 is 1, 5.72 is the length, 0.4 into 0.15, we get 0.34 cubic meter.
Overall plinth concrete cubic meter is 2.54 cubic meter. In DPC, veranda 3.5 into 3 numbers, 3.5 into 2.3, 0.15 into 1.2. Room 1, 2 numbers, 3.5 into 2.9 into 0.15, we get 3. And room 3, P1, P2, portion, rectangular portion is 3.5 into 2.35 into 0.15, 1.35 we get quantity, 1.23 cubic meter. Second portion is semicircular portion, 4 into 4.81 area, that is semicircular area 4.81 into 0.15, we get quantity 0.72 cubic meter. Overall DPC quantity is 6.19. Earthwork for filling above ground level, veranda and room, all veranda 1 into 3.5 into 2.3 into 0.4, we get 3.22. Room 1, 2 into 3.5 into 2.9 into 0.4, we get 8.12. Room 3, portion 1, 3.5 into 2.38 into 0.4. The 0.4 is the basement thick depth. We fill up to basement level, SSM basement level. P2 is the semicircular portion. The area of semicircle is 4.81 into multiply the 0.4 depth, we get 1.92. Total above ground level quantity is 16.59 cubic meter. Below ground level, total earthwork excavation minus CC bed quantity and also SSM foundation quantity, we get 11.02. Total earthwork quantity is 16.59 plus 11.02. Total quantity is 27.61. Similarly, BBM for walls, long wall L1, 3 numbers, 6 plus 0.3 is 6.3, into 0.3 is width, depth is 3 meter, we get quantity is 17.01 cubic meter. Short wall, 5 numbers, 3.9 minus 0.3, length we get 3.6 meter, into multiply by 0.3 into 0.3 meter of the roof height, total we get 16.2. And short wall, second short wall, 1 number, 5.82 is the semicircular length, 0.3 is the width, 3 is the roof height, we get 5.23. total quantity is 38.44. For parapet wall, long wall, 2 numbers, 6.3, outer to outer, 0.9 meter into 0.9, quantity is 1.13. short wall, S1, 1 into 7.9, 0.1 into 0.9, 0.71. S2, 1 into 3.8, 0.1 into 0.9, 0.34. S3, 1 into 6.44 into 0.1 into 0.9, 0.57. Total quantity of brick masonry is 41.19. Deduction for lintel, long wall, 3 numbers, through lintel, we take through lintel, 3 into 6.3 into 0.3 into 0.15, long wall lintel quantity is 0.85, and short wall S1, S2, 5 numbers, 3.6 into 0.3 into 0.15, 0.81, 1 into 5.82 into 0.3 into 0.15, 0.26, the total lintel quantity is 1.92. And opening deduction, door 4 numbers, 1.2 into 0.3 width, 2.1 is height, we multiply 4 into 1.2 into
0.3 into 2.1 we get 3.02. Windows 7 numbers, 1.2 into 0.3 into 1.35, total quantity is 7 into 1.2 into 0.3 into 1.35, we get 3.4. W1 is 1 number, 1 is the width, length of the window, and 0.3 is the width of the wall, 1.35 is the depth of the window. We multiply 1 into 1 into 0.3 into 1.35, we get 0.4 cubic meter. Total deduction quantity is 6.82 for openings plus 1.92 for lintels. We deduct to net quantity of brick masonry is total quantity of brick masonry minus plus parapet wall minus lintel minus opening quantity. We get 32.4245 cubic meter. Similarly, RCC work for lintels, similarly here we deduct the lintel quantity, we take similarly long wall 3 into 6.3 into 0.3 into 0.15 0.85, short wall S1 5 into 3.6 into 0.3 into 0.15 we get 0.81, 5.21 into 5.82 into 0.3 into 0.15 0.26, total lintel quantity is 1.92. For chajas, doors 4 1.5 into 0.45 into 0.125. We take average of 0.15 at support and 0.1 is at the free end. We average the depth, we get 0.125. The projection is 0.45 and opening width is 1.2 plus we adding bearing 0.15 on either side, we get 1.5 meter. 1.5 into 0.45 into 0.125. Total quantity is 0.33. Window 7 numbers, 1.5 is the length, 0.05 is the projection and 0.25 is the depth. Total quantity is 0.58. 7 into 1.5 into 0.45 into 0.125. W1 1 into 1.3 into 0.45 into 0.125. Total 0.99. For roof slab, portion 1 is rectangular portion and part 2 is semicircular portion. 8.1 into 6.3, thickness of slab is 0.12. We multiply 1 into 8.1 into 6.3 into 0.12. Quantity, rectangular quantity is 6.12 and portion 2 is semicircular. 1 into 5.08 is the area and 0.12 is the depth. We multiply area into depth, 0.61. Total quantity of slab is 6.73. And tar steel, total quantity of RCC into multiply by 1.5% into density of steel, we get 1135.1 kg, but round off 1150 kg. Why means we not take any wastages, that's why we round off the steel quantity. 135.1 is round of 1150 kgs. References: B.N. Dutta, Estimating and Costing in Civil Engineering.